Today on DIY Gaming, we enter level 2 of board making. The Bifold. Welcome to DIY Gaming, your source for tips and walkthroughs for making your own prototype and playtesting components. I'm your host, Brian Beach, and we're going to be fashioning a bifolding board using a similar approach to our previous board building fiasco when we made a non-folding game board. So put on your safety glasses. We've got work to do. Our supply list looks like our non-folding list. We'll need chipboard, backing paper, book binding tape, and our board printout. Spray glue and a glue stick are also needed, but not shown here because I forgot, so get off my back already. Our tools today include scissors, a ruler, and a slightly used pencil stolen from the inventory of an 8th or higher level wizard. Successful pickpocket roll needed. We're going to move pretty fast through the similarities of our previous board tutorial and focus mostly on what makes the bifold different. Experience with DIY's how to make a game board wouldn't go amiss. So cut out your board printout and measure and cut the backing to be a total of a half inch longer length and widthwise. Now hold your horses, Mr. Get a Header. Let's look at our layout. This would work well enough to get our nice quarter inch frame all around. However, we will be cutting this and pulling it apart, which makes the backing slightly longer. Now this may be okay with some of you, but I'm going to trim one side to achieve a final frame that's a little more even. In this case, I'll be trimming about an 1/8 of an inch. Where do I get an 1/8 of an inch, you didn't ask? Because I'm using thinner chipboard, we'll be doubling up in layers. So each side of the folded board, or each hemiplane, will be 2 layers thick. So when I fold the board together, I'll have 4 layers of boardy goodness that my hinge has to work around. Measuring 4 layers with a ruler gives me an 1/8 of an inch, which is what I'll trim off the edge. As you can see, the far edges are now much closer to our printout's width. So we're committed to this course, which sucks if you struggle with commitment. Why do they call it a bifolding board when it's only got one fold? Now take this backing and cut it exactly in half. Measure from both sides if you need to ensure an equidistant cut. Precision is important, which is why I score my line with the blunt edge of the scissors before I make the cut. Now check your hemiplanes and mark the direction of their configurations. The next task is a bit redundant. Score and cut identical copies of the board's sides and identify these as second layers. Then use the spray glue on one of each side's hemiplanes and glue the congruent sides together, doubling the layers and doubling the fun. No, I know it has 2 sections, but the bi is prefixing the fold, not the sections. We don't call it a bisectional board. Cut a couple of 1-inch wide strips from the backing paper. Use the bookbinding tape and line the long edges of these strips. In my example, I'm lining one strip on the dark side and the other one on the white side due to the dark and light colors used on the front and back sides of my final board. So what would we call the non-folding board? Like a mono board? Remember when we trimmed our edge down? Well, here is where we make that space back. Separate the two sides slightly more than the total thickness of all 4 layers pressed together. Now, keeping these apart is tough, so I brought in 5 of those chipboard scraps to act as spaces to hold my place. Yeah, longer spacers would have been better, but I used these super small ones anyway, stop judging me. Fold the backside's matching strip in half, hot dog style. That's long ways for you amateurs. Peel off the wax on one side's score tape and use a couple of those chipboard placeholders to space the chipboard halfway from the strip's centerfold, pressing a hemiplane evenly along the strip. Null fold.
What about Latin?
An ah-folding board? Now with the other side's wax tape removed, use all the appropriate spacers to space out the other half of the board from the other half of the board. Hey, that's great writing there, writers. Use a straight edge along the top edge to keep the board edges aligned and even. And the great writing continues. Trim your strips and prepare the second strip for the front side. This time, use the fold as a guide to keep the strip centered, letting the fold of the strip tuck into the trench a bit before full adhesive, see, is acquired. Is that even a word? When closed, the board should match up perfectly. Bicycle is two sickles. Unicycle, cycle, uniboard? Uniboard. Okay, so wrap the backing paper as we did in our uniboard video by giving a 1-inch frame to work with. Spray glue and mount the chipboard, finishing by wrapping the edges. For an in-depth detail on this process, go check out DIY's How to Make a Game Board, The Prequel, starring yours truly. If your board halves are thicker than the one I'm making here, or your backing material isn't as forgiving, you'll want to wrap your backing around the hinge as well, rather than pressing this flat. Or even better, look to our tri-fold method, which allows for a separation in the backing material. Now, once wrapped, take your printout and fold it in half to match the trench run in our bifolding board. And don't be cavalier about this fold, okay? It's the fold that tells everyone playing your game, hey, this guy or girl is both attractive and well-adjusted, so enjoy yourselves and play this game. Use the glue stick on the back side of one half of the printout, making sure you nail these edges in the center fold with the glue stick. Now, line this up as perfectly as superhumanly possible and attach the board adhering from the center out. Now repeat this for the other half using some scrap material to back up the edges for gluing. Adhere center out and allow ample time to dry before taking your fold for a test drive. Okay, after your board is properly fermented, slowly break in your first fold by gently pressing the paper into the groove to keep it from bunching up. And whammo! If that wasn't a fat rat barbecue, then I came one line dance shy of a mule frost shindig. These boards take me back to my childhood, as this style of game board has been a model for countless games and continues to be a staple in the industry. Giving your players the opportunity to interact with a board like this brings your game into the fold of long-standing traditions of tabletop gaming. Thank you for joining me today for DIY Gaming. Make sure you subscribe to our channel and like the video. And maybe send us a game board that you've made. We'd like to see them. And in the meantime, make sure you're wearing your eye protection. Mm-hmm. 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 Mm-hmm.